This is going to be the shortest cotton wash I think I've ever done on any machine. And probably the first cold wash that I've ever done all the way through. Obviously I can't remember whether I've done any cold washes or not in any other machines. But I don't think I've done any cold washes in the beko yet. So, I'm going to put a load of jumpers. Delicate jumpers to be specific. I don't usually do these jumpers first, I usually do them sort of last, but I'm running out of psycho ideas really, and I've mostly got lower temperature cycles left, so yeah, towels aren't really good for that. Anyway, let's get the washable. Actually, no, washables don't go in for delicate stuff. So let's get the wash bag, and inside the wash bag we're going to put, inside the wash bag we're going to put some tablets, also going to put a colour catcher inside as well. I'm hoping my camera brings back some more detergent and softener, because she's gone to the shop. So, there we go. So, detergent and colour catcher in here. That's just going to go up the top there. All that works as well. Softener, we're going to be using, as usual, Astra Tropical Paradise. So, about, probably want a half capful of this actually, because it's only a half load. So, not really sure whether to expect balancing issues or not with this load. Obviously, I found the bigger the load, the easier it tends to be to balance for most machines, but obviously it can be the opposite as well. So, this is just cotton cold plus quicker wash, which is dead on an hour. So, yeah, that'll be interesting. So, it's precisely 3 minutes and 10 seconds into the video when I start that. So, it should be 1 hour, 3 minutes and 10 seconds into the video when it finishes, theoretically. And these won't need to be rewashed because they're not dirty at all, really. They've probably all just been worn once or so. So just, it's a bit like a quick rinse. Thank you. tells me it's going to sort it out. average release cold, it should be about 12, 13 degrees in there.
Yep. 11.8.
So it truly is cold because that's the temperature the water comes in. I've got no idea why I've got a colour catcher in there. tyrants follow the other tank because it should drain when it hits 40. I mean, when it hits 40 minutes remaining, that is. I thought it might be no different. That was a good water level we used for this load though. The most logical water level this machine's ever used, I think. They are quite absorbent to be fair. A mixture of wool and polyester, maybe a bit of cotton in one of them, those jumpers. Anti-sense is just like an air rinse, basically. While the wash action is quite intensive on cottons, it somehow doesn't produce a lot of suds no matter what detergent I put in. Like, depending on when you see this, you may have already seen the extreme suds test, like the official attempt of the extreme suds test, where I used a full detergent cap full of fairy liquid, then added more. And then I added some tablets as well, I think, when it wasn't producing any suds. Still nothing. It was on Costa 60 standard, just like every other stress test. Most of the other stress tests. But nothing was happening. This machine is just like, it's completely anti-suds. It just hates suds for some reason. Thing is, when there's a small load in it, it builds up the suds, but they just get drained away. Which is why I went for a bigger load, like a full load, with the extreme suds test. Because last time I did that, there was a load of suds that actually appeared. I didn't record this last one. The one I'm talking about now, by the way. But they appeared and got all the way up to like the top of the door. And they all disappeared during the main wash, but they lasted longer than if there was only a small load in there. In terms of, not really, because, well, my logic is, with small loads, the suds will stay, but as soon as it hits the drain, they're going to get drained away. So they're all gone by the time it reaches a spin anyway, including the anti-suds. With a full load, they disappear on the main wash, like half within the main wash. But there is a good chance that there might still be enough suds in the clothes to do a suds lock. There may main test of the extreme sense test is to see how well it, how good the machine is to have a moving sense. So it has to produce cells in the first place to move them. And it's also a test to see how well it handles suds lock. But, doesn't seem to be doing particularly, it didn't, obviously it scored zero in anything suds related, because it didn't build up any suds to get rid of. So you can't just sort like, score 100 for getting rid of non-existent suds. That's not how, that wouldn't be fair. Anyway, in the future I might reattempt it. I do have one planned, another stress test coming up, which is kind of related to extreme suds test, but it's a bit different. Like it's an extreme overload test. They're kind of related because you're overdosing on cloves rather than detergent. We're not talking just like we're not talking an extreme overload on a quick cycle, for example. We're talking about how well does a machine handle an extreme overload on a standard cotton wash. So that'll be what the official test is. I'll probably do that next weekend, to be fair, because yeah, this weekend I just want to get it all done and then sleep, basically. Started spinning, or rather, turning. It hasn't started spinning yet. I didn't even notice it had started turning. The thing about this machine is it can be extremely quiet, considering it's a brushed motor, but it can also be quite loud as well. But the loudness is in terms of vibrations. If it was empty, it'd be really quiet. Because they use quiet brushed motors, these becos. Compared to a hot point, for example, like an old hot point WDWF machine, the ones with brushed motors, then that's so much louder than these. Which is good for me because I like loudness, but to be about like quieter machines, this is a perfect fit if you don't like the inverter ones. Well, this would have been a perfect fit for before they introduced the beko inverters. Someone in a beko, for example, if you go for one of these. Well, you could argue they're not exactly the same. Yeah, I thought we might have a few balancing issues. But to be fair, that wasn't that bad. Although they are all different sizes, those jumpers, so. That's better. In fact, that looks almost perfect balance. I mean, the drum is shaking out a bit, but it's not quite perfect balance. But it will spin that. I've got no reason not to. It's one of the most balanced distributions I've ever seen. Turned quite unbalanced, so all I can assume is when the water was in them, one of the jumpers got a lot heavier
like one of the lighter joints got a lot heavier, so it kind of balanced out. Now that the water's come out, it's no longer heavy.
But still, even then, it's not that bad.
So this has got to 600.
First rinse. I'm going to find the baskets actually. one of the baskets.
That's a lot of water. That's a significant difference between the main wash and the first rinse, to say the least. Second intro. Quite unbalanced. Okay, that's very unbalanced. Surely it wouldn't spin that. Which is the letterbox I heard. Yeah, I knew it wouldn't spin that last one. Probably spin that though. Oh, was I right or was I right? That is quite unbalanced. looking at it in real life, it's a lot more balanced than it looks on camera, because I'm looking on both from the camera view and real life at the same time, and it looks significantly less unbalanced on camera. That's with both machines, the LG and the Beko, not just the Beko. But it's because you're looking directly in it, and where the glass bowl changes shape, that's exactly where the drum rim is. So that's why you can't really see it that well. And also because you're looking pretty much straight in, but slightly down, whereas I'm looking almost fully down in real life. If that makes sense. Softener rinse. I don't actually remember if I added any softener. I guess we'll find out when they're finished. final spin. That's going to be no fun to watch if it spins like that. Can't even see anything. It won't spin that surely because we're unbalanced. Now that I've said that, it probably will. Might be lucky and we might get to see something interesting on the spin rather than just having a dark fabric against the front of the drum. That just looks like it, that's just pretty much the same distribution as before, that looks like, just without the red jumper over the front of the drum. I'll be surprised if it spins that on the distribution before. But it'll also be good because then at least we've got something to watch rather than just having a black fabric, not black, dark fabric against the front of the drum. Because that would be just boring. Especially on camera. Okay, still rebalancing. I think it will spin that one. There we go. So it shouldn't limit it because it's not been so many attempts yet. There's only about three I think that it had to rebalance. you can tell the shocks are on their way out. Now that that's been spun out a little bit, they're not even that unbalanced. Like the jumpers on the drum aren't even that unbalanced, but they've been spun a bit. You can hear the knocking noise. I assume you can hear the knocking noise. I can. Actually, maybe that's not recognisable on camera, but there is a knocking noise. I think it might be coming from this side, actually.
Whoops, be careful not to knock the basket down.
Be interested to see what it sounds like at 1200. Quite a nice motor sound, that bit. The motor sound's definitely changed. I know I say that a lot, but it has definitely changed. And I think I need to find a comparison from one of my first videos to now, just to see how different the motor is, like in terms of sounding. I'm gonna do that now, actually. All my old videos from like this time last year should be Google Photos. I don't know where that's going to come from. That was quite a smooth 1200 actually. I'm surprised considering how unbalanced it was on the round paddle. Yeah, I've got a video of it doing an old final spin. When was this? Let me have a look. Sunday the 16th of August 2020. Doing a 1200 RPM final spin with pillows. The motor's so much more high pitched compared to now. That's really interesting actually, because when the brushes are worn down over time, the motor's changing pitch. So what I think was, the brushes probably were replaced shortly before I got here, and they've only just bedded in because we only use it like on Sundays, that's all I can think of. Which is not a bad thing. Yeah, that's finished, so let's unload. I've got one more wash cycle. That we can do now, because we've only got one set of tablets left, then we have to wait for the shop to get here after that. These are actually surprisingly not that dry, because when they've just been in 1200. Okay, I did put softener in, but they smell nice. Oh, actually, this one's really dry. That one's bone dry. Yeah, I'm really pleased with this one. This red one's bone dry. That doesn't even need to be hung up, that can literally be worn right now. So that's really good. Just for reference, this is made out of acrylic. This one's really absorbent, this acrylic jumper, so 1200 for acrylic's more than enough. This one again is quite wet. Let's see what this one's made out of. This one's made from, does it say? I don't think it says. It's in every other language other than English. Very helpful, I must say. Ah, English is hidden in between it. Viscose, polyamide, and elastane. Don't know what any of those are. And this one's quite dry as well, but I think this is another wool one. Let's see what this one's made out of. Not wool, acrylic or synthetic or something. Something like that. Nylon and acrylic. So yeah, I kind of expected that. So 1200 for acrylic is great. Yeah. That's brilliant. Well, thank you very much for watching this. I think that was quite interesting actually. I think I'd definitely use Cosson's Cold for something that can't have any heat applied to it. Because for this machine, a 1 hour cycle for a cold wash is, I think that's pretty good actually. Because the main wash is about 25 minutes, which is all it needs to be. 25 minutes including filling and everything, because obviously it pauses the time at a few points during the wash. If you take it literally, it's still 20 minutes of washing on cold, so that's the equivalent to 20 minutes of temperature holding. And they've actually done really well to those, although they weren't dirty in the first place, those jumpers, they still smell really nice. So it does actually clean on cold, but obviously it's not going to get rid of any bacteria or anything, so things like bedding and face mask should never be washed on a low temperature. But anyway, that's enough of my rambling. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.